The effects of climate change on humanity are very unclear. There is not even one firm proof what will exactly happen. Everything is based on theories, which obsess the people with fear. Therefore, people are incompetent about poverty, which according to the UN is one of the biggest problems that face humanity today. Poverty isn't their theory that will occur in the unseen future, but a fact that proves itself every moment. However, trillions of dollars are spent for research against the climate change, even though it is inevitable, while the poverty can be stopped. UN first priority should be the poverty reduction, because when people extinct because of diseases, for whom are we going to preserve the climate? There are about 30,000 people that die every day because of diseases. That means one person per 3 seconds. Poverty spreads diseases more than climate change could. Due to latest statistics, it is estimated that 11 million children die every year because of diseases such as TB, AIDS, malaria, etc.
Throughout the whole 20th century, there have been people who claim that there is no climate change. There has been tons and tons of proof, however, that global warming is one of the most important current problems, and there is no time or reason to postpone actions related to combating it. Climate conditions are becoming unpredictable, and who knows, the North Pole may be entirely ice-free by the summer of next year. It is now proven the Atlantic ice shelf is losing as much as 36 cubic miles per year. Over the past 50 years, the average global temperature has increased at the fastest rate in history. Although poverty and famine are two very serious and important problems, they are only related to a certain part of humanity. Climate change, on the other hand, affects everybody. Global warming leads to alterations in the climate. A 2001 report by the IPCC suggested ice shelf disruption, such as the one of the Larsen Ice Shelf, sea levels rise, changes in the rainfall patterns, and increased intensity and frequency of extreme weather events are attributable in part of global warming. Global warming not only affects human beings, it also affects all living creatures. More and more species are dying in danger of extinction, and while we have the power to protect our lives in changing climate conditions, animals do not.
Both climate change and poverty are problems which must be stopped. However, climate change is inevitable, while poverty can be limited. If United Nations invest money in combating poverty, their funds will go straight to the poor societies and the result will be instantaneous. Otherwise, their efforts may be nonsensical because it will be just an investment in the future with uncertain results. Moreover, if United Nations invest funds in poverty, it can be useful for the future, therefore for any climate changes. For instance, poor countries will not sacrifice economic development in the cause of combating climate changes. However, if these poor communities find a solution in decreasing poverty, they will change their point of view and put climate preservation as a main aim to achieve. Thus, they will not overstep natural climate changes. According to my team, United Nations should prioritize poverty reduction over combating climate change. Firstly, because consequences of climate change are too indistinct, and secondly, because investing in poverty reduction will have both present and future outcomes.
Poverty and climate change are linked, and one cannot be solved without addressing the other. We now know that if global warming is not taken measures against, poverty will worsen. Entire agricultural sectors will be destroyed, and the subsequent spread of pests and diseases will present risks to crops. This would mainly affect poor countries. Also, a reliable climate and resources like forests and water play a key role in reducing poverty. Poor people depend on them for food, shelter, energy, and medicines. About 2 in 3 people in Africa rely on farming, which makes them very vulnerable to diseases and disasters like flooding, landslides, and drought. Climate change will affect the income-generating capacity of vulnerable populations. This means potentially increasing the number of people experiencing hunger. Many people consider global warming an issue of the generations of the future. On the contrary, the evidence of it is present in our lives even now. In the last few years, it's become clear that the rise of CO emissions in the atmosphere is having an effect much faster and more severe than once predicted. The only source of drinking water for hundreds of millions of people, glaciers, is melting. In a few years' time, we may need to alter the world maps. Sea levels are rising, and if we keep up affecting global warming in the way we used to, they might go up several meters this century, threatening millions of people's homes. Mosquitoes are spreading, bringing malaria and dengue fever with them. Weather is becoming more severe. Hurricanes and typhoons are becoming more frequent and harder to predict.